The mainstream media reports that Google is funneling its money to a P.O. Box in Bermuda. P.O. Box 6 bitch bitch. This confirms the speculation surrounding Google Chrome's logo. That is to say that Google has been peddling the mark of the beast in plain sight. Just like Lucent Technology, also known as Lucifer Enterprise, whose former headquarters was at 6 Bitch Bitch 5th Avenue, New York. You couldn't make this stuff up if you wanted to, and the reason this is being done should be obvious to you, as these companies, Google and Lucent, are giants in the telecommunications field, and therefore it gives us a feel as to what these companies are thinking about. They're thinking about evil, they're thinking about destruction, about being diabolical. Google insiders will tell you as much. If you listen to what they're saying, they're talking about post-human society. That's right, you heard that correctly. Post-human. After human. When man merges with machine. When man will be no more. That is their endgame, to wipe out humanity. Where resistance is futile. That kind of thing. That's what they're thinking about. That's what they want to bring into the world. And that brings us back to what we were talking about yesterday. The weaponization of cell phone towers. To recap that discussion, a cell phone tower is a giant microwave oven on a stick. Cell phone towers use a magnetron or an oscillator, like a microwave oven, to make microwaves. That's how they communicate. Radars use the very same technology. That part that's beaming into the dish is a magnetron, just like a microwave oven and just like a cell phone tower. Now let's do a quick comparison to put things into perspective so that you can appreciate, so that you can wrap your mind around what we're trying to tell you here. Two hair dryers together use about 2,000 watts of power, or 2 kilowatts. That's the same amount of power a telecommunications satellite uses to send a signal 20,000 miles away back to Earth. So two hair dryers equal the power used by a communication satellite to broadcast the length equivalent to the entire planet. And the Earth is about 20,000 miles wide. To broadcast the entire Earth, it takes 2 kilowatts, two hair dryers. Now a microwave oven uses 1,000 watts, or 1 kilowatt. Here's the damage 1 kilowatt can be done by somebody when they take a magnetron out of a microwave and turn it into a ray gun. This is just a small example of a low-tech weapon running on 1,000 watts. Then you have these things here, these huge towers of death. Now each row in this tower, an array, or a set of dishes or rectennas or whatever you want to call them, is connected to a cable with a maximum power output of 300,000 watts, or 300 kilowatts. That's 300 microwave ovens. We base that conservative estimate based on the gauge of the cabling that's running up to one of these arrays. They're estimated at 300,000 watts per cable. Those aren't fiber optic cables running up to those arrays. It's a thick copper gauge transmission line quality cable running up those towers. Now if there's 10 cables, that's like 3 megawatts of power. And these cables are out there to output power to the magnetron, not for data transfer. That's an important point. These cell phone towers are weaponized. There's no other reason to have this much power running up the cables. It isn't for data transfer. Now, FCC regulations limit normal transmission per array to about 400 watts. To put that into perspective, 1 watt from your phone can go 25 miles to the nearest tower. A 1,000 watt magnetron on a stick can blow shit up. And these towers have a 300 kilowatt power line running up to each rectenna. And who knows, there could be an amplifier at the top of these towers that steps up the power even more. The point is here, ladies and gentlemen, is that these companies, like Lucent and Google, could turn up the juice at any time and nuke a town. They could nuke the entire country without any warning, without anybody being able to protect themselves. They could cook them like a boiling frog in the middle of the night. This infrastructure is not only in place, it's built up with multiple levels of redundancy. Every big city has thousands of these death towers. And all that needs to happen is for an AI from Google or whoever to come in and nuke everybody at once and take over. Who out there remembers that movie Terminator? Well, Google doesn't have to send a Terminator to every door or launch a nuclear strike. It can just turn on these cell phone towers to maximum and cook everybody within the city limits within an hour. And then just send in the Terminators to mop up the countryside. And if it isn't Google that does it, it can be somebody else, like the real people that brought us 9/11. Or better yet, say we elect somebody that's batshit crazy evil. They could fake a reason to turn on the last line of defense, the anti-foreign invasion, anti-zombie apocalypse defense network. Oh, these contingencies are out there, ladies and gentlemen. Like a nuke in every city, a nuke from each side, so that makes it at least 2 nukes per city in the world right now. That's how serious things are. That's how the clandestine world works. Add in these cell phone towers of death and the question becomes why? And the answer is because when they're ready, they'll end it all and move on to reconstruction of the post-human age. Our only possible defense is to stop them now, to stop them from getting what they want, which is the technology that lets them go post-human. They need a super AI, a drone army, a clone army, an army of Terminators, and a fully automated workforce. And the technology that lets them upload into the Borg hive mind and become an avatar forever. A virtual reality matrix where they can live their lives happily ever after. That's what they need, and as soon as they get it, they'll proceed with the extermination of those that will not comply. We've already seen the FEMA coffins everywhere, and so we know those who will not comply will be terminated. And the end game is clear, they want to go post-human. This scenario isn't 200 years away, it's right around the decade. What's important to remember here is that technology is punishment in disguise. It all has a side effect, and it's obvious that these companies that are running this technology, they are not our friends. Worse yet, they run our government, they control our food supply, our water supply, our air supply, but have no doubt, their end game is the death of humanity. And so when you look at these cell phone towers of death, remember what you're looking at. There is no hiding from these towers, even though they try to hide these towers from your eyes' view. Because they do not want you to see how outnumbered and how outplayed and how ready for the slaughter you actually are.